actual election of MK Abiola and Babagana Kingibe, as his running mate, was annulled by the then President Ibrahim Balemasi Babangida. So I think now to restore that, President Muhammadu Buhari, in his wisdom, restore that and also shifted the 2nd October to June 12th, or take it back to June 12th for the celebration of that Democracy Day, so that they can remember, Nigerians can remember what has happened as a result of that. So I think it's a very good thing, and I believe that all Nigerians will, even though we have this pandemic now, I think Nigerians will celebrate that, even if it is in their homes, or maybe in an isolated place where there are a lot of physical distances to celebrate this June 12th.
From 1999 to this 2020 now is 21 years of uninterrupted democracy. How well would you say Nigeria has fared?
No, this means that we are getting better in terms of democratization in this country. Because when you look at when the country got independence and democracy was put in place, there were a lot of military intervention. Until now, you know, we have some kind of intervention in the democracy, but military also always take over. But now, since we returned back in 1999, there is no military turnover, which means that Nigerians are now getting matured to continue with the kind of democracy that we are having. Because I believe that every country starts from the scratch. When we look at other developed nations like USA, like England, where they have so many centuries of democracy, years of democracy, I believe that with our own here, we should be able to continue with the democratic process without the military intervention. That will also enhance the economy, it will also enhance the relationship between the geopolitical zones that we have. It will also create a lot of diversity, you know, in terms of, you know, having unity in the country, and also mobilization of people within the country, and also succeed in making better. So I believe that with this, without the military intervention, even the military are not even interested in coming to take over. Because there's nothing wrong in what we are doing. Whatever challenges that we have is something that can be addressed, just like any other country in the world. So I believe that we should also be taking care of our military and also all the security agencies. I believe that the sky is our limit.
Still talking.